Welcome.
Yes, good luck, good fight. Good luck.
过世的以色列人质挥手说拜拜，哈马斯还跟他们说要保重。明明是绑匪和人质，却笑着说再见。这超违和的一幕，以色列痛批哈马斯直到最后一刻都拿人质来作秀。
You see terrorists wave goodbye to the hostages, but those same terrorists murdered their loved ones and violently kidnapped them from their homes.
哈马斯释出影片想洗白，但是以军也没再客气，把同段影片拿来。和哈马斯攻击屯垦区的凶残作为同框对比，强力播送。
You see terrorists cooperate in releasing hostages, but those same terrorists force their captives to wave and smile at gunpoint.
还说哈马斯在影片中明显命令人质继续挥手，要配合演戏。双方即使暂时休兵，但是舆论战火没停歇。以军更指控哈马斯用救护车当掩护，是行之有年的惯用手法。
2004, during an exchange of fire in Gaza, Hamas terrorists were caught using ambulances marked with the Red Cross and UN insignias to evacuate armed terrorists. 2009.Hamas attempted to hijack ambulances from Al-Quds Hospital in Gaza City.
指控哈马斯看准了国际法，明定医院和救护车是战事中被保护的目标，甚至还自己准备好多辆救护车，以便混淆视听。哈马斯和以色列间不断针锋相对，就连最新同意将停火延长一天，都是一波多折。
This is CNN Breaking News.
It is 9 a.m. in Gaza, where Israel and Hamas have agreed to extend their temporary truce for another day. The news came just minutes before the six-day pause in fighting was set to expire.
压线宣布停火再延一天。据了解，原因就是哈马斯愿意交出的人质数目和之前说的不一样。
10 live Israeli hostages, not 7 women and children alive and 3 dead bodies. 10.If they didn't get the 10 live hostages, the pause would not continue.
That they believed that Hamas still held enough women and children hostages for 2 or 3 more days.
哈马斯说要释放7名妇女和孩童以及3具遗体，但是以色列坚持要10名活口，而人质四散加萨，有些甚至还不在哈马斯手上，是在伊斯兰圣战组织的手中。哈马斯得想办法凑出人，这一来一往之间，以色列态度踩得很强硬。
We need to be ready to mobilize as soon as the government instructs us to do so, on one hand, but also to respond to events on the ground, including explosive devices that Hamas detonated against our forces on the ground.
以军不断重申，只要哈马斯没有依约交出10名人质，随时都会重新开火。而其实过去这几天，以军在约旦河西岸的动作也是没停过。挖土机直接开进了哲尼难民营区，把民宅都给铲平。这名妇女说，以军闯进她家，从卧室对街上开枪，家里被打成马蜂窝。
They took my husband, bound his hands, and pushed him outside in the cold. She says, they kept him there from 6 in the evening until 5 in the morning.
而之后，她才刚新婚的儿子房间被搜过一遍，人也被带走。还有这名妈妈，18岁的儿子被榴弹波及，指控以军。不让他们把小孩送去医院。
I was sure we were going to the hospital, she says. We went downstairs. A second officer was there and made the medics put the stretcher down.
而他眼睁睁看着自己的孩子在家门口失血过多身亡。而同时间，在耶路撒冷又发生了一起新的恐怖攻击。警车、救护车赶抵现场，但是已经太迟，至少3人死亡。
When a gunshot from 2 terrorists in a car drove by this bus stop over here, shooting and killing a 16-year-old girl and injuring 10 others in different levels of severity.
一大早不到8点钟，两名枪手开车到进耶路撒冷路口处，直接扫射。这时间、手法和10月7号攻击那天都很类似。尽管两名枪手当场被击毙，但这势必又让以色列民众的恐惧开始蔓延。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。